Settimana Internazionale Coppi at Bartali is a classic stage race in the northern part of Italy. There was the parkour, pretty lumpy, sort of hilly part, 1.2 kilometers, 7.3% was the climb. Has a steep section of 12%, done three times, but finished with quite a long way to go, about 19, 17 kilometers to the finish. So there's a lot of decent competitors here today. Obviously, the main reason you clicked on this video is Mark Cavendish. He is here. He's obviously riding for the kind of quick step who are on the left-hand side of the picture ahead of us, and he is looking outrageously good. Second in a recent race. You can see his head just popping through now. Second in GP, Jean-Pierre Monser. We also have like Fabio Fellini going for GC. Ineos have a strong team with Ethan Hayter, Eddie Dunbar, Sosa. Got Vingegaard for Jumbo Visma. We've got Lanterns mate Berrick. We've got a lot of decent riders here, to be fair. Kevin Codioni, a big fan of him. Marechko for the sprint, as well as Albanese. So you can see the back is here. Another bloke, Paul Double, has been on the channel before, but unfortunately the video had to get deleted due to some controversy out of my control. But he's a really good young British climber, and I reckon he's going to go pretty well in this stage as well. So if you don't know Settimana Internazionale Coppi a Bartali, the first stage is like a sprint stage, then basically TT on the same day. So this is stage 1A, and then 1B is the team time trial. And then it's just sort of hilly, lumpy race all around. So pretty exciting. But Vino Zabu KTM had Yapan Mrechko. It was probably one of the favourites for this stage, I reckon, along with Cav and Ethan Hayter, and maybe Albanese. But there wasn't, you know, crazy sprint talents here. Yakima Mosca for track is okay, but you can see it's very strung out. 4 kilometers to go to the final, so really you've got to be pretty far up, otherwise the chance of you winning this race is very low. And on the left hand side is Jakub Mrechko's team, who just keeping, you know, towards the front. Aolo Cometa for Albanese on the right hand side, and you know, it's just a bit chaotic. There's not really super strong teams in terms of like pure numbers. There's only really 6 riders in each team, so you know, a couple GC contenders, maybe someone who's worked early. There's not too many people who can actually control the race at the end, so obviously it's not going to be the smoothest and sort of most least chaotic finish. Going over this bridge over the left, and then straight to the right, as thing. It's like, you know, a classic Italian place, narrow roads, got to be near the front just to save energy more than anything else. Like, look at these guys sprinting out of the corner. But the question is on everyone's mind, is about Cavendish. So obviously, you know, can he actually get back to the same level? You know, he hasn't raced really some super high level since Tour of Poland, I believe it was last year, where, you know, his best result was 14th on the day, which was pretty decent, like, but it's not what you expect from him. You know, won over 30 stages in the Tour de France, pretty mental. We've also got Vendrame for the Italian national team as well, forgot to mention them, which is, you know, a strong old man as well. 3 kilometers to go, Astana looking pretty good. They're just going for GC. There's no one really that it got who can sprint incredibly well. Mrechko is tiny bloke, reminds me of Caleb Ewan. I did make a video ages ago saying he was going to be good, but he hasn't really progressed much. He won a lot in the Asia Tour. He's got like 30 pro wins, but most of them were in the Asia Tour. And the good thing with Quickstep and Cav is that they always know to stand back. So you won't see them now, because there's no need. It's 3K to go. We don't need to be on the front. You can see Ben Swift moving up now. He's asking, you know, trying to figure out where Hayter is. But like, there's no need to be so far forward at the moment, because like in the last kilometer, you can just move up. If you just whack it big time towards the last kilometer, then you can move up. And Cav is on the outside here, maybe 6-7 wheels back. So near enough the front that there shouldn't be too many crashes. It shouldn't be too chaotic. Each of the corners he's not having to do a huge sprint out of. But he's not on the front. He's not wasting his teammates. And I think Quickstep only had maybe 4 or 5 riders here. So, you know, they've really got to spare the teammates as much as possible. And one of them was Shane Archibald, who's obviously going to be his last lead-out man. So you don't want to get him in the wind too early. And Aolo Cometa doing a decent job, along with Vino Zabu KTM, as well as Sunweb, just keeping the pace pretty high. 2 kilometers to go now. So you've really got to be towards the front. And as you can see at the back, it's just chaos. It's so strung out. You know, they'll be going 55, 60 kilometers an hour around all these corners, around the straights, and then around the corners, sort of breaking a little bit. And the rubber band thing, I mean, when you're at the back, it just stretches out. And you can see this guy sort of took the corner not too crazy and then really launched it now on his beautiful Coratec bike with SRAM red ETAP axis. Surprisingly, it has actually worked on this one. It looks like he's doing a super strong thing. It's got toe covers on, which is what we love to see. Mrechko's third wheel spinning super high cadence, which is a classic sprinter job, because they really don't want to tire out their muscles and leave it all for the final. I can't see Cav yet, but there's about to be a huge crash on the left-hand side of the road because people have decided that they want to go left instead of right, and they chop across. And that's the thing. If you're not towards the front, there's going to be crashes. It's going to be chaos. And we can see it's about to be here. Yuskatel lad goes down. Huge crash. Natnab Sisfion, who I think is a really solid rider. He's Eritrean lad, rides for Nippo Vini Fantini. And he had a big crash, and unfortunately, I think he finished the stage, but he was really someone who I think is going to go really, really well in the future. But you can see, like, you know, it's just chaos. Everyone's down. Poor Yuskatel person. But it was basically caused by some Astana bloke who chopped someone else's wheel across. And as a result, everyone was down. But you don't need to dwell too much on this, because at the front, we're about to see why. But look at the Astana lad in the middle. He just chops the Yuskatel lad's wheel. He then overlaps his wheel and cheerio. But luckily, Cav is in, like, fourth, fifth wheel. Mrechko is to the right in second wheel. And Albanese is also about fourth wheel, just behind his teammate as well. And you can see the flying mullet, Shane Archibald, is on the front. He's got, just checking that Cav's on his wheel. Cav is pretty much on his wheel, and he's like, right, it's time to go. As soon as there's a crash, you'd want to just, you know, punish anyone who's too far back. And now you can see this is exactly what Quickstep are doing out of this roundabout, absolutely drilling it. Ben Swift's now second wheel, leading into this sort of long, lazy right-hand corner going towards the finish. Ethan Hayes got very good position. Cav, in my opinion, now is in perfect position. He's about three wheels back. Jakub Mrečko is on his wheel. And to be honest, this looked like a really, really strong lead out, because Ben Swift is so good over these last couple kilometers and sort of last couple hundred meters. And on the left, we've got Albanese going really, really early. And then Cav is going just on the left-hand side, had to launch quite early. Mrečko went so, so late and just held it all the way to the line. Cav comes on the left-hand side, but he missed out. Unfortunately, just couldn't get in the draft. So we're going to go watch that again, because of the camera work. It was a little bit chaotic. But you see here, Cav goes as far as he could, I guess, in the shorter direction, and just misses it on a bike throw. But I think if he'd managed to be on Mrečko's wheel instead of in front of him and followed him, he definitely would have had a better chance. Because you can see here, I mean, it's really touch and go, but I think Cav was just tiring when it came to the line. Normally, Cav on a bike throw is pretty good at it, but I think, you know, he went for a lot longer sprint than Mrečko. Mrečko managed to stay in the wheels a little bit longer, while Cav seemed to go all the way around. And obviously, that was not the desired line. I mean, it was technically the shorter line. But you see here, Mrečko's there. Cav is on his wheel. And this is why I don't get why Cav didn't stay on his wheel a little bit longer. He just seemed to, you know, go off his wheel and then to the left. And I maybe it was a shorter line. But, I mean, I think, yeah, it definitely wasn't ideal for Cav coming so late from where he was. Mrečko is absolutely delighted. Buzzing is what you would say. First proper win in quite a long time for Mrečko. So you can see here's the results. Some pretty decent names, but no one absolutely mental. And here's the finals. Anyway, cheers for watching. Hope you did enjoy this little video, and we will see you in the next one.